In this video, we're going to start to talk about something called data consistency. This term refers to the ability of our database to make sure that the information that we are inserting into it and working with actually makes sense, and that all these different references between tables actually line up in some way. Let me show you what I mean. Whenever we insert a photo into this photos table, there are three different possibilities that we need to consider. First, we might try to insert a photo that is tied to a user that actually exists. That would be like all the insertions we have done so far. We might try to insert a new photo. Let's do that right now. Just kind of imagine it. So here's some new photo, and we need to decide what user this photo is associated to. So in the first scenario, or in the first case I want to consider, we would add in an ID here that actually exists inside the user's table. That would be the values 1, 2, 3, or 4. Let's say it's 1. So if we do that, we are creating a photo that references a user that actually exists. If we do that, everything works okay. Everything works as expected. We insert the photo, no problem whatsoever. We can then run some queries to fetch all the photos associated with that user or do whatever else we want to do. So let's now consider the next case, the case in which we insert a photo that refers to a user that does not exist. What would happen there? And hey, what should happen? First, let's make sure this scenario really makes sense. So I'm going to delete that last user I just added. And now we're going to imagine that we attempt to add in a new photo down here. So I'll give it an ID of 8. And then maybe in this scenario, we attempt to attach it to a user that does not exist. So maybe for whatever crazy reason, we accidentally put in a user ID right here of 345,000. Well, there's no user with that ID. So we now have a record that doesn't point at any existing user. So what would happen here? Well, if we really think about this, this is a scenario that kind of doesn't make a lot of sense in anywhere, world, shape, or form. So if we ever try to insert a record and have an ID inside of a form column that points to a record that does not exist, we're going to end up with an error. That's what's going to happen. Let's try to test out this scenario really quickly, and we can see very easily that if we try to associate a photo with a user that doesn't exist, we end up with a nasty error message. Okay, so back over here, very quickly I'm going to do a select star from users, just to remind you that we only have users with IDs 1 through 4. I'm then going to attempt to insert into photos, and I'm only going to put in a URL and a user ID, and then some values of whatever, just once again, some random URL. And I'm going to try to point to a user that definitely does not exist. So we do not have a user with an ID of 9999. Let's try to run this and see what happens. So sure enough, we get a nasty error. It says here that we are trying to insert some new record into the photos table, but we are not allowed to do so because it's going to violate a foreign key constraint. This term foreign key constraint means that Postgres wants to make sure that whenever we set up this foreign key, it tries to reference a record that actually exists inside of the user table. In this case, there is no match, so we end up with an error. Now, this is a very good feature to have. It makes sure that you are not going to accidentally insert data into your database that just doesn't make sense at all. Now, the last scenario I want to think about, we might have photos inside of our application that are not actually tied to any user whatsoever. Who knows, maybe we want to have some image of the day that pops up whenever a user first logs into our app, and maybe that photo is not intended to be really associated with any user whatsoever. So what would we do in that case? Well, if we want to insert some kind of photo that is not going to reference any user at all, then instead of putting a 999 right there, we will instead put in null, like so. The value null is very special in SQL and Postgres. It means there's no value here. It's just nothing. So we can now run this, and we are able to insert that record successfully. Now if we delete that and replace it with a select star from photos, we get all of our different photos. And for our very last photo down here, you'll notice that the user ID column has a value of null right there, which means there is no user associated with this photo. So those are the three scenarios. Let me fill in this last one right here. We're going to put in a value of null for the user ID. So those are the three scenarios we have to think about when we are inserting data when it comes to handling consistency. If we try to reference a remote row that actually exists, everything works. If we try to reference a remote row that doesn't exist, we get an error. And then if we want to insert a record that doesn't have any actual association, we'll just put in a null for the foreign key value. Okay, so that's just insertion. But we need to also think about what happens when we try to update a record or delete a record as well, as it relates to all this foreign key stuff. So let's take a look at some other scenarios in just a moment.